Hello and welcome. This is the third problem on the problem series where we are discussing challenging problems of JEE Advanced 2020 paper 1. We are given a set S of complex numbers satisfying modulus of Z square plus Z plus 1 is equal to 0. We need to choose the right options out of given 4 options. Let's read the options carefully. The first and the third options are commenting on the values of modulus of Z plus half. The second option is commenting on the upper bound of modulus of Z, and the fourth option is commenting on the number of elements in the set S. The fourth option is the easiest to work on. We observe that the possible values of Z square plus Z plus 1 are e power iota theta, where theta lies in the interval 0 to 2 pi. For each possible value of theta, we get a quadratic equation in Z. And each such equation has a solution in the set of complex numbers. So there are infinitely possible values of Z satisfying the given condition. This makes option D incorrect. Now we move to options A and C. It is clear that both of these options cannot be correct. Since we need the interval for modulus of Z plus half, so we complete a square and the given condition is equivalent to modulus of Z plus half whole square plus 3 by 4 is equal to 1. Now what? How can we move forward? Is there any way to get some inequality by using this relation? The answer is yes. We can use triangle inequality for complex numbers, which gives modulus of z1 plus z2 is less than or equal to modulus of z1 plus modulus of z2 for any two complex numbers z1 and z2. By using this inequality, we get modulus of z plus half is greater than or equal to half, which proves option C correct. Now let's move to option B. The journey ahead is a bit difficult, so listen carefully. Unlike last time, the triangle inequality is of little use now. We have to figure out some other way to check option B. It is well known that omega and omega square are the roots of the equation z square plus z plus 1 is equal to 0. So we can write it as a product of z minus omega into z minus omega square. All is fine so far, but it is still unclear how this is useful to meet the objective. The idea is to use the fact that modulus of z1 minus z2 is nothing but the distance between two complex numbers z1 and z2. Instead of checking option B directly, we assume its negation is true. If this assumption leads us to a contradiction, it would prove that our assumption was false, and hence option B would be true. This method is popularly known as method of contradiction. The negation of option B is that there exists some Z in S whose magnitude is greater than 2. Now let's see whether this statement leads to contradiction or not. It is well known that omega and omega square are two complex numbers which lies on unit circle centered at origin. We have a complex number Z whose magnitude is greater than 2. In other words, that complex number lies outside the red circle, which is equivalent to modulus of z minus omega is greater than 1. And similarly, we get modulus of z minus omega square greater than 1. Fortunately, this leads to contradiction. Thus, option B is correct. We conclude by marking B and C correct options. This completes the solution. This was a good problem where we need a bunch of ideas to deal with. The single problem tests our understanding on geometrical representation of complex numbers to the cube roots of unity. The problem becomes more challenging when one side triangle inequality is the key idea for options A and C, and the other side, the option B, is of entirely different flavor, which requires the understanding of geometric representation of complex numbers along with the understanding of cube roots of unity. Problem writers definitely deserve an applause for writing such a multi-idea problem. That's it in this video. Tomorrow we shall come up with another amazing problem based on integrals. Needless to say that you should attempt it before watching the solution. Thank you for watching the video. See you next time.